Normal respiratory rate for an adult depressed is about 10-12 breaths in 1 minute. The respiratory rate is measured as a number of inhalation or exhalation per 1 minute, and it is usually done at rest. People with chronic diseases, when we have mild forms of heart disease, asthma, diabetes, cancer, many other conditions, breathe a little bit faster, about 15-20 breaths per minute. During last stages of disease, when people are severely sick or they are terminally ill, respiratory rate is much greater, is about 30-40 breaths per minute. There are many studies like related to, for example, cancer, cystic fibrosis, HIV, many other conditions. Normal respiratory rate in children is higher, and here is a table that provides typical numbers depending on the age of a child. The ideal respiratory rate is only about 3, 4, 5 breaths per minute, and when a person has this respiratory rate, of course we are again talking about automatic or unconscious breathing pattern, like when a person is not aware about his or her breathing, or breathing during sleep, because during sleep generally the respiratory rate is nearly the same as people have at rest. The ideal respiratory rate that provides maximum body oxygen content. And in order to have more oxygen, breathing should be slower and lighter. And therefore, the ideal respiratory rate is only about 3-5 breaths per minute. On this diagram, you can see different breathing patterns and corresponding results for the body oxygen test. So there are ideal breathing pattern, normal breathing pattern, which we can find in medical textbooks, the breathing pattern which is common among sick people, and finally there is a breathing pattern which corresponds to vast majority of severely sick people. And people breathe very fast, but body oxygen content is very low. And that, of course, is the key factor that promotes or advances chronic disease. If we think about various other conditions, respiratory rate, of course, can vary a lot. For example, during pranayama breathing exercise, even ordinary people can start doing pranayama with only 2-3 breaths per minute. When you take deep inhalation, hold breath, slowly, slowly exhale. This is how pranayama should be practiced. And we again hold breath. But yoga master, if he practices pranayama, of course, for maybe some years even, are able to do the same exercise with only 0.5 breath in 1 minute. That means we take one breath in 2 minutes time. And that, of course, indicates that the breathing at rest is already very, very slow, and it's not so difficult for them to practice pranayama with such very slow breathing rate. At the same time, there is opposite exercise, which is called fire breath. Bastika, like when a person tries to be very, very fast, but with very small tidal volume, only about maybe 200 milliliters, so that we get more CO2, and that provides more oxygen for body cells. During this exercise of yoga, hatha yoga, fire breath, the respiratory rate can be about 100-120 breaths per minute. And if we think about physical exercise, breathing rate or respiratory rate is also higher. It's common for many people to breathe about 50-60 breaths in 1 minute, but since we generate CO2, oxygen transport is in fact can be improved, especially if we breathe only through the nose during physical exercise. When people practice breathing retraining, the respiratory rate gradually becomes slower, and that's also an additional factor that indicates improved body oxygenation. You can find more details about respiratory rate in relation to the body oxygen test and other parameters, for example, CO2 in the alveoli, minute ventilation, heart rate, average numbers, in the Buteyko table of health zones, on the web pages of normalbreathing.com.